Welcome to Totally Cool, Totally Art Video Art Lessons. My name is Clint, and I'm going to be taking you through a project today called 20 Circles. Basically, we're going to take 20 circles, flat circles, and make them into a 3D circle or ball. It's a fun project. It's something you can do at home with some easy materials, and I think you'll get a kick out of it. Every time I make one, I just get excited about it. So let's get to it here. What you're going to need is, I'm going to use a paper bag for this one. Something you probably have at home. I've used soda, cardboard, you can use regular paper, colored paper, cardstock, anything really, any type of paper. But for today's purpose, I'm going to be using a paper bag from the grocery store. All right, well, let's get into it. The first thing we're going to do is that we are going to make some circles. Now, drawing a circle from scratch can be pretty difficult. So what I did is I went to my cupboard in my kitchen, and I just grabbed, this is kind of a soup bowl. We're actually in Austin, Texas, but this one happens to say I love New York. I kind of like this big circle. It's kind of big. So what I did is I put it in the paper bag here, and I traced around edge. Just pretty easy. And I did that 20 times. 20 circles. So you're gonna need 20 circles. That's the first step, is to cut up 20 circles. Next step, after you have them all kind of drawn out, you're just gonna cut out those circles. This is where your scissors come in here. This one. Knock these out. You could get with a friend and do this with a friend. It's pretty easy. And there you go. You got to cut up whatever that circle is. Whatever circle you choose, it doesn't matter. The bigger the circle, the bigger the dome will be in the end, or the 3D ball. So you take 20 of those. Now I've taken the liberty of cutting out 20 circles, so I have mine pre-cut right here. The next thing we are going to do is we're going to create an equilateral triangle. Now an equilateral triangle is a triangle that has 60 degrees on each side. That is kind of the magic of this whole project. But a circle makes a beautiful equilateral triangle inside of it. You take a compass, put it down, and you make one 60 degree triangle. I don't know if you can see that. Oh, what I've done is I made one of those. I made it out of a piece of cardboard, and then I went inside of my cutout pieces of paper, put that triangle in there, and take my pen and I just made that shape. And you can see what that looks like. It's something like this. So those are the big things, big steps. Trace 20 circles out of a paper bag, cut them out, make a fist right in there like that. Trace that on all your circles. What you're gonna wanna do is you wanna fold along the edges of all these triangles. So you're basically creating that triangle shape. Just like that. And I'm gonna go ahead and do these for all these. And as you can see, I'm just about done folding them. It just took just a few minutes, not too long. And just folding them on that inside triangle. Let's see what the last one here looks like. All right. Now this is a fun project. Now I've done this project with several times, several different people. And the next step, what I can do is, you can see this is a, beauty of this project is you can scale it up so big. And this is a big circle. I did this with a conference. And what I did at that conference, I gave each person or each table a big circle and had them decorate this big circle. Obviously, the triangle, the equilateral triangle, was already on there, and just let them go for it. And that's what you could do. You could take some time and do individual drawings on these. You could put anything you want. You could paint it, markers, anything. But basically, you can do that, not on your own. And that, it kind of adds to the design of the overall sphere when you're done, which is pretty fun. So the next part, after you have all those, basically what you're gonna do here, and I have another thing all set up, you're gonna take 10 circles and put them together. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. And this is gonna create the middle section of our sphere. You can kind of see it's gonna look like that. I glued all these together, and then you're also gonna do 2, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And this is where the glue comes in. You're gonna start to put these together like this. And what you're gonna wanna do is connect those circles just like that. And you're gonna wanna make a straight line. You take some glue. You don't need a lot. You don't need a lot, but you kind of want to give that whole little edge. And get right on that edge. You're going to put that together like that. Another thing that I've done, and the reason I have that stapler here, it does kind of goes quicker. With a stapler, I'm just going to put two staples right pretty close to the edge. And if you do the stapler, you probably don't need the glue. I like the glue, but it depends on you. So I put those together, and I'm going to make this whole thing. Now when you start to do it, the one thing you want to do is you want this to be a straight line. And I'm just going to use the stapler just to kind of go a little bit faster for you. And I'm stapling it right on that edge. I'm stapling it right on that edge. Just two staples is enough. And you can see, yeah, there's a little bit of space in there, and that's why I do like that glue, but maybe I'll stick some glue on there too. It does give for a nice finish. But I'm going to take a second and put all these together. The first one is 10 in a row, 10, just like this one, just example right here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. And I'll be right back. So again, this is our 10 right here. Put that just inside. Now we're going to make this part. This is going to be the top. It's a little different, just 3 to 4 and 5. And you're going to see it's going to come together like that. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And I'll start with that. And you're going to make two of these. 1, 2. And this probably is the trickiest part because it's a little bit different. Put 3 in a row, and then you put one here and one here. And that's just a little bit different than the 10. And that, I have made a mistake there. It's easy to go back and fix it, and you'll figure it out pretty fast, but it's just a little bit different design. Just like this example here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And I'm gonna make another one of these. When you staple it together, just lay it flat. Do that for this one also. So, those 20 circles, This is tan. And you put these, you connect these together. There we go. Kind of leave it flat. You can kind of see how it takes a second sometimes just to figure out where that is. And you're going to connect those. Again, now you could glue those. The staple, you can see, it does speed the process up quite a bit. So now you have the middle shape, or the kind of the core, and these tops. The next thing you're going to do, just kind of one by one, you're going to, and they just kind of go right along that line again, you're just going to add one right, two staples. And the one thing that glue does also, which I do like, it makes it a little bit stronger in the end. But sometimes it's hard to resist the speed of the stapler. Cool. Now look at that. That's kind of a dome, which is pretty cool. This project, I'm calling it a sculpture, but it could be applied to architecture as well as other things. It's just kind of fun to make. And I'm just gonna add this other side. And there you have it. So you stapled all these together, you come up with your circle. It's pretty cool. Now, as you can see, I've done a few other ones, like with the construction paper, it's really fun, and you get different colors, and also, I did this one with a friend the other night, and you can see I added some drawing to the edges. I really do think that taking some time to decorate each circle can really add a lot of fun and cool design elements to your sphere at the end. And like I think I showed you earlier, and you can scale it up. Again, this is whatever size you decide to make your circle at the beginning is how big your overall dome will be in the end. You can make a circle that's 5 foot tall, and you can make a huge dome. It would be pretty exciting. And again, adding the drawings and designs onto those circles can really be a big deal. And ten circles makes the middle. 2, 5, and 5 make the top and the bottom, and you put them all together, and you get this cool dome. I think you'll have fun. These, and they're really strong. Just out of paper, they get really strong. Well, thank you so much for making some art with me, making some cool sculpture. I can't wait to see what yours look like, and hope to see you again here at Totally Cool, Totally Art Video Art Lessons. These are brand new for us because we are kind of in the quarantine, the coronavirus days. It's 2020, so we can't go out to classes right now, so we're teaching from home. It's kind of a new thing, but we're all learning together. Be safe and be well. Someone that you might be interested in who's kind of taken this idea of a dome is Richard Buckminster Fuller. In the 1940s, 1950s, a place called Black Mountain College, he taught, and he really used the triangles to start an architectural revolution, per se. He made these things called geodesic domes, and kind of a brand new design that no one was thinking of, just using these triangles. Very cool stuff. So if you ever want to look up a little bit more about an artist that used this kind of these simple ideas to make some really cool architectural things, Richard Buckminster Fuller is a really cool guy. So it could be architecture, it could be the sculpture.